हेलो फ्रेंड्स, कैप्टन विजय बैक अगेन. आई एम रियली सॉरी एट अ सेशन, बट द प्रीवियस सेशन वॉज यू नो इट वॉज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, सो वी हैड टू एक्सटेंड इट फॉर सम टाइम, सो आई एम रियली सॉरी. सो दिस इज पार्ट टू ऑफ टैक्सेशन फॉर सी फेयरर्स, द वेरी हॉट टॉपिक. सो लेट्स गेट आवर डियर साचित, आवर सी ए, माई डियर फ्रेंड ऑन बोर्ड. सॉरी टू कीप यू वेटिंग. I'm sorry I had to disconnect you because Sachet was waiting for a long time. So let me get him back. Hello Sachet.
Hello.
The sweet guy.
Hello. Thank you.
I'm sorry. Sorry for keeping you waiting for 20 minutes. Previous session, you know, got a, because the topic is such that, you know, 1 hour is definitely not enough. So I would like to apologize for, you know, coming late, because I believe many of the other guys also maybe must be eagerly waiting for this tax issue, because, you know, job ho na ho, paisa zaruri hai.
Correct. But the previous session was also interesting. Even I was there in the previous session, and it was for everyone, like how to manage the stress and how to manage everything on board and even offshore also. So it was interesting, and
that's why I got Surbhi. She is a great speaker, getting from a non-seafarer point, and I believe, you know, from her conversation, I believe she has even a lot to offer. So I'll request her to talk, you know, give some motivational, you know, speeches for our deck cadets who have been, like, you know, stuck. Sorry, my phone got disconnected. Sorry. Okay, so I'll not waste any more time. Let's my phone is kind of slipping. So friends, the viewers is building up slowly. Okay. 1 second. Screw it. Okay. Is it okay now? Yeah.
Yes.
So we have our dear CA Sachit back with us. And our first episode, the first part was, I know, surprisingly hit. I never expected that. And so thank you for, you know, it was quite technical, as you know. But then later on, lot of people commented on my YouTube page as well. You must have seen it, you know, a lot of appreciation.
Yes.
Also, it was my maximum views on IGTV so far. You know, I have taught people ROR. Rules of the road, I have taught them anchoring, I have taught them whatnot, but the maximum views kisko mila? Taxation for seafarers. So I think I've hit the right spot. So again, for people who don't know Sachet, okay, sweet guy, he's a CA and he's an expert in seafarers income tax filing return. He's personally filed more than 1,000 seafarers ITR. He has been guiding and his advice is for free. Please follow him on Instagram. Please check his website and get in touch with him. So part one is already uploaded on YouTube. If you have not seen, please watch it. And this part two, we will try to cover up the questions that we missed during our part one. And some of them might get repeated a little bit. All right. So let me just get back. You talked about, you know, the NRA days calculation that you would discuss in part two. So if you can just, and again, you know, seafarers, we are not high, no, the just the layman terms, if possible.
Yes. So I'll explain again. Basically, the simple rule is that you should be outside India for 184 days in leap year, and in 185 days in non-leap year. So basically, this is the basic condition. Now, how to calculate this 184 days outside India? That is the main thing. So 184 days to pata hai, but how to calculate that? So basically, there was a circular issued in 2015, the notification number 70/2015, wherein it was specifically for seafarers that if any seafarer has joined any voyage which has its origination from India and the destination is outside India, or the origination of the voyage is outside India and the destination is in India, then in that case, we would consider the CDC dates. And while considering the CDC dates, we have to consider both the sign-on and sign-off date as outside India. So Basically, if you are on a foreign going vessel, FG vessel, which is mentioned in the CDC, and your sign-on is from India and sign-off is from outside India in foreign port, or vice versa, sign-on from outside India and sign-off from in India, then in that case, you will consider CDC dates, and both the sign-on and the sign-off dates would be considered outside India. And in rest other cases, for example, if you have sign-on from foreign port and sign-off is also from foreign port, in that case, you will consider the passport dates. So, while calculating the passport dates, you need to take care that the departure date and the arrival date, both are considered as in India only and not outside India, whereas in case of CDC, the sign-on and the sign-off dates are considered outside India. And in passport, the departure and the arrival date is considered out, is considered in India. So, excluding this, we have to calculate. So, we have, you don't have to consider the departure date and the arrival date in 184 days and in 185 days. So, this is the things which need to be taken care while calculating 184 days. And I suggest that we should not be cut to cut 184 days. It is always better to have 189 days, 190 days. That is always better. Yes. So this is the basic rule. Everyone should take. Yes.
Okay. So basically, it's 184 and 185. Guys, please do not keep cut to cut. Okay. Some calculations here and there. Ek din ke wajah se, you know, you don't want to pay unnecessary the tax slab that you will fall in. Okay. Okay. Next question is, what are the biggest seafarers? Seafarers, you know, which you have come across, you know, many seafarers so far. In terms of their financial planning, if you can just share. I know one for sure, life in what you call life term insurance seafarers take it very late.
Yes, correct. So in terms of the biggest mistakes, first I will go in terms of where to what do they make mistake in ITR filing, income tax. So as far as income tax is concerned, what are the biggest mistakes, and then I go in financial planning. So the biggest mistake in income tax return is that all the seafarers, like in the starting initial years, they take their salary in their savings account. So that is the biggest mistake, taking salary in savings account. And also, while they are NRI, but still they are maintaining their savings account. So once you become an NRI, you are not allowed to maintain the savings account. So as it was earlier, even in the part one also, we discussed that there is a residential status as per the FEMA Act and as per the Income Tax Act. So in FEMA, you see the intention, like your intention is to sail outside India every year, even though in particular financial year, you have not completed your 184 days, still you have to keep the NRE account always intact. You have to not maintain your savings account. So once you start sailing, you should make a point that never keep your savings account, convert that savings account into NRO account and also open another NRE account. So this is the biggest mistake which all the seafarers normally make, and that makes that if you take in savings account, then entire salary becomes taxable. Now another thing which the seafarers make is that they do not complete their 150,000 slab, which is given under ATC section 80C, which gives that 150,000 deductions you will get. So that those slabs are not completed by most of the seafarers. Now I will go to like where to invest. Where to invest while completing this 150,000. That I will go in further. So first I will complete what are the mistakes that the seafarers do. Second, another thing is that when they are sailing with Indian company and they have completed their NRI days. So what happens, you know, the seafarers do not inform the Indian company that I have completed my NRI days, and the Hello.
Yeah.
Yes. So I'll repeat again. Basically, if you are in Indian company, so Indian company normally tends to deduct TDS. So if you will inform the Indian company that my NRI days are completed and do not deduct my TDS, so there won't be any headache of claiming a refund from the income tax department. So if you inform well in advance, then that would be better. And also, one thing which I've noticed is that many seafarers do not link their Aadhaar card with the mobile number. So this thing is very necessary while filing your ITR, and various other things are required. So Aadhaar, linking Aadhaar with mobile number is essential, because after filing income tax return, you need to e-verify that income tax return. So if you have completed your Aadhaar linking with the mobile number, so then it is always easy that your e-verification is completed very fast, and you don't need to send your ITR to Bangalore physically, doing it courier. So that is not required. If your Aadhaar is linked with mobile number, so then that is not required. Also, while filing your ITR, you should give all the bank details to the person who is filing your ITR, or even if you are filing your ITR, because you should not hide any of the bank details, whether that particular bank detail, bank account is dormant or whether it is active, you have not used at all. So you should not hide any of the bank details with the income tax department, because if you hide, then it would result in misreporting and underreporting of the information or undisclosed information, and it would attract penalty, unnecessary penalty. So that is. And also, when you are having high value transactions, like when you are having investment in fixed deposits or investment in immovable property or any other high value transaction, so you should always file your income tax return. That is the biggest mistake that seafarers make. Now, coming to the investment part, where normally, so I will cover what all the investments the seafarers should make. So that will cover basically what are the mistakes that the seafarers do. Yes. So basically, first thing is, as you told, that LIC and term insurance. So where to invest, whether to invest in LIC, whether to invest in term insurance. So I would suggest that when you are at young age, it is always better to invest in term insurance, because the premiums are very low. And when you reach a specific age, 35-40, then you can invest in LIC, and you can, or you can convert that term insurance into life insurance. So basic difference between term insurance and life insurance is that in term insurance, you do not get the only when there is uncertainty, like death or any other uncertainty, then only you get the term insurance. Whereas in life insurance, you have the advantage of maturity benefit as well as the term insurance, as well as the death benefit. So you have dual advantage. But if you see in terms of premium, the premium in term insurance is very low, whereas in life insurance, it is high as compared to term insurance.
Okay.
So these are the basic things. Yes.
Yeah. One of the waiver, if you can just read the comment, is requesting you to slow down a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. I'll make it a little slower.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So basically, this was the difference between LIC and the term insurance. Now, yes. So whatever. So at the time of withdrawal, if you withdraw life insurance and if you withdraw your term insurance, so many have queries that whether that would be taxable or not. Like, it's a huge amount. Like, the surrender value is very huge amount. So whether that would be taxable or not. So as per the Income Tax Act, if your premium amount is 10% or more than 10% of the surrender value, then only it is taxable. But if your premium amount is less than 10% of your surrender value, then it is not taxable. So this needs to be kept in mind, that make sure that your premium amount does not exceed your maturity value. If it exceeds 10%, if your premium amount exceeds 10% of the maturity value, then in that case, the withdrawal amount would be taxable. But generally, I have seen that the premium amount would not exceed 10% of the surrender value. And premium amount in that particular financial year, not the premium amount what you have paid over the years. That is not considered, only in that particular financial year. So that needs to be taken care of. Second thing is the investment is the public provident fund. So many seafarers have questioned that whether I can have a public provident fund, or whether it is allowed or not once I become an NRI. So basically, when you are a resident, and at that time, if you have kept your, if you have opened a PPF account, and after some years you have become NRI, then you are allowed to open, you are allowed to keep that PPF account. But as a fresh NRI, if you invest in PPF account, that is not allowed. So the only thing is allowed is if you are a resident, that time if you have opened a PPF account, and after becoming a resident, you become a non-resident. then you can continue to keep that PPF account. That is not an issue. Now, whatever interest I am receiving in PPF account, normally if you see, people keep in SBI account, this PPF account. So, whatever interest I have received, that is tax-free. That is not at all taxable. And whatever you withdraw from PPF account, that is also tax-free. Whatever you withdraw, that is also tax-free. Now, the question is, when can you withdraw in PPF account? As per the PPF Act, when can you withdraw? So, only after 15 years, you can withdraw the PPF account, not before that. So, you have to keep investing every year in PPF account, and only after that 15 years you can invest. But in special circumstances, you can withdraw PPF account after 5 years. So only in case of education, if you have need of education or only in case of education and medical aid, then in that case you can withdraw after 5 years. Now what happens if you do not close your account after 15 years? So generally you can keep PPF account up to 15 years. But what happens if you do not close your account after 15 years? So in that case, you can further extend your, like automatically get extended up to 5 years. So it gets extended up to 5 years. Or you can apply to the bank wherever you have kept your PPF account to invest that account for more than, for 5 years basically. So till 5 years it gets extended. Now another investment is housing loan. Housing loan is a type of investment only, because you are if you invest, like if you are making housing loan payment, EMI payment every year, so that also you will get as a deduction under Income Tax Act. Now you will get 150,000 deduction only. This housing loan is covered under 150,000 only. So this 150,000 has lot of things because there are a lot of things in which this 150,000. So the principal payment is allowed in this this ATC deduction, which is 150,000, and the interest part is separately allowed. So whatever interest you pay, now one thing you need to take care of is that if you are given that property on rent, if you have let out that property, now there are two types of properties. One is a let out property and one in which you are staying, self-occupied property. So if you have let out that property, in that case, whatever interest you have paid, that is allowed as a deduction. So there is no cap on interest. And if you have self-occupied that property, if you are staying in that property and you are making monthly interest payment, then in that case, the cap that the government has given is up to 2 lakhs. So in case of self-occupied property, it is 2 lakhs. In case of let-out property, there is no limit on the interest part, not the principal part. Because principal part is covered under ATC, which is, there is a cap of 150,000 rupees. And only interest part is covered in let-out property and self-occupied property. So this is the major thing. Next is, you can invest in Sukanya Samridhi account. Sukanya Samridhi account, that is that. So many have questioned that whether an NRI can invest in Sukanya Samridhi account, or whether if I become a if I'm a resident, that time I have to invest, when to invest in Sukanya Samridhi account. So basically, if you are an NRI and if you are living in India and your daughter is a resident, because I would first like to explain what is Sukanya Samridhi account to all the viewers who are watching. So basically, Sukanya Samridhi account is it is under Beti Bachao Andolan, wherein the campaign of the government, wherein you are allowed to open Sukanya Samridhi account only if the child is less than 10 years of age, and that account can be opened up to 21 years of age of that particular girl child, only girl child. And so for one particular girl, you can open only one Sukanya Samridhi account. And per family, you can open, like, so for example, if you have two daughters, so you can open only two Sukanya Samridhi account. And now if you have three daughters, you cannot open for the third daughter, because only two Sukanya Samridhi accounts can be opened per family. That is the restriction which has been given. Yes. So that is the major restriction which the government has kept. And so coming to the part where when can you open a Sukanya Samriddhi account? So if you are an NRI and if you are living in India and your daughter is a resident, she is also living in India, then you are eligible to open a Sukanya Samriddhi account. Now if you are an NRI and you are living outside India and your daughter is living in India only, then you are eligible to open Sukanya Samriddhi account. But if you are
Hello guys, technical issues, I don't know, my side or his side. Interesting. A lot of things, even I didn't know, I have a Sukanya. Yeah, we are back, hopefully. Yeah, I can hear you. Now it's better.
Hello?
Yeah, Sachin.
Yeah, am I audible now?
Yes. You are audible to me.
Hello.
Yes, Achit, go ahead. Tell me. Sukanya, you mentioned only two accounts are possible in a family.
Yes. Just hold on. My earphone has gone.
अपना yep.
yeah so I was talking about Sukanya Samriddhi account. So basically the crux is that if you are an NRI, so if you are a resident, you can anyways open Sukanya Samriddhi account. But if you are an NRI, you can open Sukanya Samriddhi account if you are living in India and your daughter is also living in India. That is the crux. But if your daughter becomes an NRI, then you have to close that Sukanya Samriddhi account. So the crux is that if you are a resident and your daughter is a resident, you can open Sukanya Samriddhi account. If you are an NRI and you are living in India and your daughter is also NRI,
then cannot. Okay, guys, sorry. Yeah, network issues, eh, Arch?
Hello?
Yeah, Arch, network issues jyada ho rahe.
Yes. Now it's clear, I guess. Yeah. So, the crux is that if you are a resident, you can open, and your daughter is a resident, you can open Sukanya Samriddhi account. And if you are an NRI and you are living in India and your daughter is also a resident, you can open Sukanya Samriddhi account. That is the crux. Now another is that what about National Saving Certificate? So there is another investment called National Saving Certificate. So NRIs are not allowed to open invest in National Saving Certificate. These are allowed only for
resident
individuals. Yes. Another is that if you are paying tuition fees of your children, that is also allowed under section 80C, wherein the cap is 150,000. So even that is allowed. If you are making a tuition fees of your children, even that you can claim as an investment and deductions under Income Tax Act. Another is if you have made an FD, 5-year tax saving FD. So you have to inquire with the bank that there are some tax saving FD. and there is a lock-in period of 5 years. So like after 5 years only you can mature. The maturity period should be for 5 years. So those are allowed as a deduction. And also there is one more FD called post office time deposit. So post office ka jo FD hai, even in that if you invest, you can claim as deduction. Another investment where you can make is mutual fund. Now
mutual
funds are highly
And he's back.
Hello. Yes. So, if you are investing in mutual funds,
Sachin.
Mutual funds.
No, I'm not able to hear you.
Hello. Hello.
Nope. Nope. I cannot hear you, Sachin. You will have to reconnect through the Bluetooth option, I believe. Yeah, guys, Sachit ki awaaz aa rahi, meri nahi aa rahi. Please type in.
Hello.
Okay, guys. Yep. I hope
Hello.
We can hear both voice. Okay. Both of you are audible. Okay. Yeah. Sachit, continue.
Yes. So I was talking about mutual funds. So where can you invest in mutual funds? Basically, only those mutual funds which are tax deductible. So there is a special name called as Equity Linked Savings Scheme (ELSS).
ELSS.
So if you invest in ELSS mutual funds, those are tax deductible. But so what is basically equity linked savings scheme mutual funds is that those mutual funds majorly invest their chunk of investment in equity. So only government has given exemption only to those individuals investing in ELSS mutual funds. Now these ELSS mutual funds are locked in for a period of 3 years. So if you sell it before 3 years, then you cannot sell. Basically, you cannot sell it before 3 years. So these are locked in for a period of 3 years. So only those tax deductible mutual funds which are locked in for 3 years and they are ELSS mutual funds, those are only those have tax benefits. Another is investing in ULIP, unit linked insurance plan of LIC. So those are also eligible for deduction. And so next is National Pension Scheme, NPS. So this is an additional deduction. You will get an additional deduction of 50,000. So what I was talking earlier about 1,50,000, this NPS is not included in this 1,50,000 slab bracket. It is separate, 50,000 rupees. So if you invest in National Pension Scheme, you are allowed to invest as an NRI also. You can invest in NPS. As a resident also, you can invest in NPS. But now the catch is that if you want to withdraw, so there is a restriction given. So I will talk about that also. So if you are a person who is less than 60 years of age, and now you are investing every year in NPS and claiming tax deduction. And if your age is less than 60 years, in that case, you can withdraw only 20% of what amount you have invested, only 20%. And what you have withdrawn, that is tax-free. That is not taxable. And balance 80% is invested in annuities. Annuity, wherein you get pension every month. But now if the amount you have invested is less than 1 lakh, so you can invest entire amount. There is no restriction on 20%, 80%. If your investment is less than accumulated balance in the NPS account is less than 1 lakh, then you can withdraw entire amount. But if your age is above 60 years, then instead of 20-80%, it is 40-60%. So you can withdraw 60% and 40% is invested in the annuities, wherein you get pension every month. So this is the structure of withdrawal of National Pension Scheme. Now another investment is you can invest in Mediclaim. Mediclaim, and there is a difference between Mediclaim and life insurance. Mediclaim is for your if you have any accident or if any uncertain event happened, not in death, but any accident. So you can, whatever hospital bills is there, you can have that deducted from your Mediclaim. So in Mediclaim, you get an additional deduction of 25,000. So this is an additional deduction apart from 150,000 what you get. Now, another is if you are staying in a rented premises, if you are paying rent every month, so you can also claim deduction of what rent you are paying. So whatever rent you are paying, you can claim a deduction of rent. So, but you should not have any house property in the vicinity area. Like, aisa nahi hona chahiye ki aapka already us udhar area mein property hai aur aap deduction lene ke liye aap rent pay kar rahe ho. So undue advantage should not be taken in that. Yes. So these are the major investments and what are tax deductible, where you could not invest. These are basically the summing up of all the investments.
Yes. मुझे तो एक दो ही पता थे, but I think you did your homework quite well, and I believe apart from that network issues, this video I will watch again, क्योंकि you covered literally everything जो एक seafarer invest कर सकता है. We talked about NSC, SSY, LIC, NPS, ULIP, ELSS. So, you know, thank you so much. पूरा कवर हो गया, I believe after this video, you know, सबके doubts, investment part clear हो गए. Then mistakes you covered, you know, what are the mistakes? आधा savings account, yes, seafarer savings account में पैसे डालना चालू करता है, बाद में उसको पता चलता है कि NRI account होना चाहिए. NRO account you covered, and that TDS, if you know, instead of claiming it from the income tax, you can, you know, proactively पहले बता दो. Aadhar card and mobile linking is very important, and do not hide your Swiss account. बोले तो अपना India में all the छोटा छोटा account that you maintain, no, disclose everything to the income tax department, because ultimately they will come to know your PAN number, say, you know, pura bio data pata chal jata hai, and file IT. Okay, next I would like to ask is other seafarer, suppose he goes to join the ship and he goes to any foreign country, he stays there for 5 days and pata chala ki ship was supposed to come, but you know, it has changed coast aur wo kahin aur chala gaya. Now he's again coming back to India. So wo din, suppose he stayed in USA for like 10 days, okay, and he's come back to India. So those 10 days abroad will be counted as NRI days?
Yes, it would be counted as NRI days because you had gone for employment as it is, but because of unavoidable circumstances, you had to come back. So you can always argue that it is for employment only and not for any other purpose. And we have all the papers that I had entered into a contract letter with the recruitment company, and you can see my contract letter, and I was supposed to join from this date, and the ship was embarking in this particular port on this date, and we have all the proof to prove to the department that it was for the purpose of employment. So no need to worry in that case.
Okay. Another question is like, if any seafarer, you know, have property or usne rent pe diya hua hai kisi ko aur usko usse rent mil raha hai aur wo rent fir taxable, he cannot put it in any savings account, because as an NRE active seafarer, he cannot have a savings, so he'll put it in his NRO account. Now that is taxable.
Yes. So whatever income you have earned from India, whether it is rent, that is taxable. Whether it is rent or dividend, or if you have sold any shares, or if you have sold any mutual funds, or if you have sold any property, so whatever is concerned with Indian land, whatever you have earned, anything from India, that is taxable. Whether you are a resident, whether you are an NRI, anything you have earned from India, that is taxable.
Okay. One more, like, I believe you already covered this, you know, seafarers initially they keep this misconception ki फाइल करने का जरूरत नहीं है, जब टाइम आएगा तो देखा जाएगा, बट यू ऑलरेडी कवर्ड दैट व्हेनेवर यू आर बाइंग एनी प्रॉपर्टी यू शुड ऑलवेज फाइल योर रिटर्न्स बिफोर बाइंग एनी प्रॉपर्टी. ओके
Yes, I would like to add this one more point in this, that when you should file ITR, and so basically every whether you are a resident or you are a non-resident, every person who is, so government has given that even if your income, like the basic idea is that if your income exceeds 2.5 lakhs, then you have to file your ITR. The basic condition is that if your income exceeds 2.5 lakhs, then you have to file your income tax return. Now, for an NRI seafarer, normally you receive your salary in NRI account, and that is not taxable only. So that is not counted in 2.5 lakhs. Now, so basically we advise seafarers that you should file your ITR in case you want to avail loan in future. So normally banks ask 3-4 saal ka income tax return, and apan fir baad mein jaate hai ki arre mere purane saal ka window close ho gaya hai, ITR abhi bhar nahi sakte. So instead of doing that, we should plan in advance that अगर मुझे लोन लेना है, अगर प्रॉपर्टी खरीदनी है, तो we should file ITR. And also, if you are having substantial investment, अगर आपका FD में investment है, अगर आपका property में investment है, तो you should always file your ITR, because आपका investment किया है, and department can always ask कि आपका source क्या है, what is the source of making such huge investment, and आपका source क्या है. तो basically we have to disclose to the government that इसमें आपको tax बनना नहीं होगा, but we have to disclose कि वी आर एन NRI seafarer एंड एज पर दी प्रोविजन ऑफ इनकम टैक्स एक्ट वी आर नॉट लाइबल फॉर इनकम टैक्स बट वी आर अर्निंग सैलरी फ्रॉम दिस इज अकाउंट एंड यू हैव टू डिस्क्लोज आवर बैंक डिटेल्स सो इट इज ऑलवेज एडवाइजेबल दैट यू शुड फाइल योर ITR.
ITR. ओके यस नाउ आई बिलीव यू कवर्ड एवरीथिंग इन जस्ट ओके वी ऑलरेडी कवर्ड दिस यू नो इन अ प्रीवियस सेशन बट यू नो बेस्ड ऑन योर एक्सपीरियंस यू थिंक एनी लीवे कुछ मिलने वाले अपने सीफेयरर्स को फॉर लास्ट ईयर एंड ऑल्सो दिस ईयर
यस सो आई एम होपिंग दैट सीफेयरर्स को मिलेगा बिकॉज अभी रिसेंटली वेडनेसडे को एक सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जजमेंट आया है वेर इन एक NRI है दुबई का जो इंडिया में आया था 1920 में एंड बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड ही कुड नॉट गो बैक to his home country, that is Dubai, and he stayed in India for 182 days or more, and he was qualifying as a resident. So he filed a petition to Supreme Court considering that because of COVID I could not go back to my home country Dubai mein, and so he usne petition mein aisa likha ki those who are considered as an NRI in financial 1920 automatically exemption should be granted in financial year 2021 irrespective of your number of stay in India. So, agar aapka financial year 1920 mein complete ho raha hai NRI days, to 2021 mein COVID-19 ki wajah se aapko relaxation mil jayega. So, aisa ek petition file hua hai Supreme Court mein, and let's see aage kya aata hai iska decision. Because okay. Supreme Court ne direct kiya hai NRI ko to file a representation to the Income Tax Department ki aap aisa aisa batao. And CBDT, जो CBDT, which is the apex body of the Income Tax Department, वो इसमें they are framing circulars and they are also looking after this. And lot of petitions have been filed. So we are considering कि government कुछ अच्छा करे for all the NRIs and even seafarers. Yes.
That's something good news after so many days के बाद कुछ सुनने को मिला. भला उस आदमी का जिसने petition file किया Supreme Court में. Okay. Yes. What are the लीगल लाइबिलिटीज वट आर द लीगल लाइबिलिटीज अगर किसी ने इनकम टैक्स फाइल नहीं करा है और उसका इनकम उसका NRI स्टेटस यू नो मेंटेन नहीं है फॉर यू नो क्वाइट अ नंबर ऑफ इयर्स तो पनिशमेंट्स क्या क्या है और कितना फाइन जेल उसके बारे में कुछ आइडिया दे दो
यस यस सो बेसिकली इफ यू फाइल योर रिटर्न एंड इफ इट इज लेट फाइल्ड देन आपका 1,000 to 10,000 पेनल्टी रहेगा इफ यू लेट फाइल योर इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न बट इफ यू हैव नॉट फाइल्ड एट ऑल मतलब आप जिस साल रेजिडेंट थे आपके NRI डेज कंप्लीट नहीं हुए और आपने फाइल ही नहीं किया अपना इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न तो उसमें कैसा है कि इट विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज एन अंडर रिपोर्टिंग ऑफ इनकम और मिस रिपोर्टिंग ऑफ इनकम एंड इन दैट केस आपका 50% से 200% तक पेनल्टी दे कैन चार्ज ऑफ द टैक्स अमाउंट सो आपको टैक्स अमाउंट दे विल कैलकुलेट टैक्स अमाउंट कि इतना टैक्स बनता है आपका एंड बेस्ड ऑन द टैक्स अमाउंट तो यू हैव टू पे टैक्स अमाउंट दैट इज कंपलसरी And on the tax amount, you have to pay 50% to 200%. That depends on the department. how much leeway the department can give. So this is the penalties what
seafarers
need to do. Yes. So it is a huge penalty.
Yeah. Nahin, when you said 50 to 20, to I mentioned 15 to 20. But later on, 50 to 200 करके मैं टाइप नहीं मतलब लिख नहीं पा रहा था उसको फिगर को ना. सो दैट्स अ व्हाट यू कॉल वेरी थर्ड डिग्री पेनल्टी यू कैन से बिकॉज ऑलरेडी एक तो पेंडिंग टैक्सेस तो मतलब इनकम टैक्स जो भरना तो पड़ेगा ही प्लस ट्वाइस दैट विल बी लिटरली ह्यूज अमाउंट उस टाइम पे. या फोर टाइम्स इट विल बी अ ह्यूज अमाउंट उस टाइम पे. एंड इफ दैट टाइम इफ इट डजंट हैव दैट मच ओके उस टाइम पे उसके पास इतने पैसे हुए नहीं तो
So they will attach your bank statement, bank account.
Okay.
And you cannot do any transactions from bank account. And अगर आपकी कोई property है, तो they can attach your property also. So recovery proceeding start हो सकती है उसमें.
मतलब seizure हो जाएगा उसके बाद वो अपना जब्त कर लेंगे.
हाँ. So आपके जो नाम पे जो property है, वो भी जब्त कर सकते हैं. आपके आपका bank account जब्त कर सकते हैं. And first they see from the refund. तो अगर आपका कुछ refund बनता है पुराने सालों का. So first they will adjust from the refund and agar wo refund amount is very less matlab usko adjust nahi ho raha then they will attach your bank statement and properties.
Oh nice. Actually apna live session na isse start karna chahiye hamesha. Penalty se start karna chahiye phir uske baad curiosity badh jati hai. Okay. We talked about COVID relief, you know, hopefully kuch milna chahiye. I do have सुकन्या वाला मैं कर रहा था मतलब वाइफ के नाम पे ना सेफ बेट वाइफ के नाम पे कर दो. वाइफ इज वर्किंग शी इज फाइलिंग टैक्सेस प्रॉपरली एंड शी इज अ रेसिडेंट इंडियन सो वाइफ के नाम पे आई वॉज मेंटेनिंग SS बट आई डिडंट न्यू कि यू नो इफ टू डॉटर्स थ्री डॉटर्स देन ओनली टू यू कैन टेक SS Y.
करेक्ट.
देन आई थिंक आई एम डन सो लेट मी जस्ट Not many. Okay, a few points on FCNR account. I have no idea at all. If you have any idea, please share.
Yes. So an NRI can maintain. So NRE, NRO accounts, an NRI can maintain. But there is another account called foreign currency non-resident account, FCNR account, and it is a USD account. So you can maintain that account, but avoid taking salary in FCNR account. Take salary in NRE account only. So FCNR account, mein aap transfer kar sakte ho. कुछ अमाउंट एनआरई अकाउंट से एफसीआर अकाउंट बट इट इज नॉट एडवाइजेबल फॉर एनआरआई सीफेयरर्स बिकॉज़ एनआरई अकाउंट एंड एफसीआर इट्स ऑलमोस्ट वन एंड द सेम. देयर इज हार्डली एनी डिफरेंस. ज्यादा डिफरेंस नहीं है. थोड़े बहुत टेक्निकल डिफरेंस है बट यू शुड मेंटेन एनआरई अकाउंट ओनली एफसीआर. और अगर आपने एफसीआर से एफडी किया हुआ है सो एनआरई से एफडी किया हुआ है तो वो तो उस पर जो इंटरेस्ट आता है दैट इज एग्जेम्प्ट. बट अगर आपने एफसीआर से एफडी किया हुआ है तो उसमें भी जो आपको इंटरेस्ट आ रहा है दैट इज ऑल्सो एग्जेम्प्ट. सो दोनों में इट इज एज इट इज एग्जेम्प्ट. सो इट इज बेटर टू मेंटेन एनआरई अकाउंट एंड नॉट टू मेंटेन एफसीएनआर.
बट आई थिंक इंटरेस्ट रेट्स आर बेटर इन एनआरई अकाउंट कंपेयर टू एफसीएनआर.
यस यस यस.
ऑलराइट. नेक्स्ट लिक्विड फंड. सो दैट यू नो म्यूचुअल फंड्स का एक पार्ट आ जाता है. सो व्हाट अबाउट लिक्विड फंड सर?
लिक्विड फंड्स. सो अगेन लिक्विड फंड्स में भी वेदर लिक्विड फंड इज अ इक्विटी ओरिएंटेड फंड और अ डेट ओरिएंटेड फंड that again we have to check. So agar liquid fund is what exactly you can redeem very easily. Liquidity aapko aa jati hai. So that is called liquid funds. So again aapka 3 saal ka lock in period hai to aap liquid fund agar invest karoge to aap redemption jaldi nahi kar paoge. So basically aapka 3 saal ka lock in period ho jata hai. So liquid funds I don't think it is eligible for investment but you have to check with the what type of liquid fund it is, whether it is equity oriented or debt oriented.
Okay. If you see any questions, please you know feel free. I am not able to see. बाकी तो यार वो अपने इधर उधर के फालतू comments भी मिलेंगे. Asking you know my person other questions. Interview ले लो कब से वो बेचारा पीछे पड़े मेरे. Ignore those. Sir, NIOC अगर 12th किया तो company sponsorship. Sponsorship questions ignore. Sorry. So let me just think. Okay.
So one is, do you advise on opening a PPF before becoming an NRI? So yes, you can open a resident account. When you are a resident, you can open PPF account. That is always advisable. because as an NRI you cannot invest in PPF. So always when you are a resident, you can open a PPF account. So that is always better.
Okay. Again, PPF, I have opened it using my wife's name. So, my wife doesn't even know what kind of investments are. This ULIP is a good scheme. ULIP, I have seen, you know, most of the bank, jidhar bhi jao, wo apne hamesha ULIP chipkane ka try karte.
Actually, ULIP is not a, because ULIP mein aapko premium jyada bharna padta hai, and aapko jo maturity benefit hai, wo मतलब ज्यादा रिटर्न्स नहीं है बेसिकली यूलिप में. एंड अभी गवर्नमेंट ने बजट 2021 में यूलिप में काफी रेस्ट्रिक्शंस दे हैव ब्रॉट इन अ लॉट ऑफ रेस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑन यूलिप. सो अवॉइड इन्वेस्टिंग इन यूलिप मतलब अनलेस आपका क्योंकि इन्वेस्टमेंट पर्पस इज बेसिकली योर एलआईसी एंड टर्म इंश्योरेंस दैट इज ऑलवेज बेटर. यूलिप इज नॉट बेटर.
एलआईसी इज आल्सो अगेन यू नो रिटर्न्स आर क्वाइट लेस कंपेयर्ड टू द फ्लक्चुएट अपना अपना मार्केट स्टैंडर्ड्स के हिसाब से. ओके अनदर थिंग इज
दिस वन क्वेश्चन इज दैट
या Good.
One question is that what tax, like how much tax I need to pay if I become a resident? There is one question.
I think it's covered in your videos. NRE mein there is no tax, no? You have to just file zero.
NRE mein there is no tax, but if tax amount suppose you have to pay, so I'll tell that slab rate. I mean, so if it is up to 2.5 lakhs, then it is exempt. If it is about 2.5 lakhs, and between 5 lakhs, like 2.5 to 5 lakhs, then 5% is the tax what you need to pay. And if it is above 5 lakhs but less than 10 lakhs, then you have to pay tax at the rate of 20%. And if it is above 10 lakhs, then you have to pay tax at the rate of 30%. And in this, you have to, like it is slab rate. So only about 10 lakhs, it is 30%. And so you have to, so there is a separate calculation. If it is, for example, if your income is coming to 13 lakhs, 12 lakhs, for example, 12 lakhs. So only on 2 lakhs, you have to pay 30%, like about 10 lakhs. And between 5 lakh to 10 lakhs, it is 20%. So that comes to 5 lakh pay 20%. So that is around 1 lakh rupees. And 2 lakh 50, say 5 lakh ke beech mein, it is 5%. So only on 2 lakh 50 thousand, you have to pay 5%. So it is progressive taxation, not complete 30% you have to pay.
Yeah,
so that is the tax rate what you need to pay. Yes.
Okay, so basically slab wise jitna amount banta hai utna percentage of tax bharna hai aur jo 10 lakhs
yes
se exceed kar raha hai, suppose if you have earned 30 lakhs so 10 lakhs hata ke 20 lakhs ka it will be 30%. 10 lakhs tak depending har ek slab pe jo percentage hai wo calculation kiya jata hai, but I think the CA takes care of that.
Yes, correct.
Okay, now another thing, like suppose somebody is buying a property, aajkal kafi mehenga ho gaya, so you know, somebody has bought a property of 2 CR, okay, 2 CR, now he already has a term insurance of 2 CR, do you advise him? Then again, you know, when you go for this bank loans, home loans and all, any bank, they will send their insurance wale bande piche chhod denge, they'll force you to buy a, what do you call, the insurance for the home insurance, you can say. Okay, and then their premiums, and I've seen that experience, you know, their premiums are way too high. If I see the same thing, yeah. If I think, okay, if I just 2 CR flat, okay, now I need a 2 CR extra term insurance. But if I see the premium for that, term insurance, that will be quite less compared to what this guy's charge. So first thing, do you advise taking a home insurance? Second thing, if you do, then what are the best options? I mean, this question was not planned. It came to my mind.
So normally, you know, if you take a home loan normally banks have tie-up, they have their insurance companies also, for example, HDFC Bank, HDFC Life Insurance. So they always try to sell their product always they try to sell their insurance along with the housing loan. So, I mean, that is compulsory only. Otherwise, the bank do not provide loan. So you have to take that insurance from the particular the HDFC, for example, HDFC Life Insurance. So yes, there is no option, like you cannot avoid that. So there is no option to take.
I would also recommend, if you know, it's better to take the insurance, because you know, in this seafaring job, chances of accident injuries are quite high. So it is always better, and do not touch your term insurance. So when I bought my house, I took a separate lump, but the one who came to my home, I'll just share my experience. The one jo mere ghar pe aaya tha na, he quoted me a very high premium. And wo dekh ke, I just told him, okay, I'll just think and, you know, get back to you. Then I checked, term insurance is quite cheaper. I'm still saving, you know, a lot of money. Then I gave up. I was like, okay, I'll find another way. You know? But then when I went to take my first disbursement, whose time pay that one lady was there in Andheri office. Now these agents come, you know, they'll quote all this ulta bulta figure. But that lady, she told me, have you taken this? I said, no. Then she started, obviously she has to sell, no? HDFC ka hi papu hai. So usne mujhe pata, and then the premium that she offered me was almost one third of what that agent offered me. And that time I was like, okay, now this is interesting because this is close to the term insurance ka premium, which I can afford. So usne bola, and this one can be included in your pre-EMI as well. Nothing like it, you know, just form one bhara. And I took the home property loan ho gaya. So at least my term insurance is separate. Home ka insurance cover ho gaya. So do your homework. Always advisable agar bada amount hai. So always take a home insurance.
Correct, correct. Yes.
All right, then I believe nothing else. We covered most of the stuff. And again, nicely, I mean, your homework was superb. I mean, I had my questions, but I can't even ask you because you covered literally everything. So hats off to you. And I'll be saving this video again in my Instagram and YouTube as well. I'll share you the link. So this video is basically all about, you know, mistakes that a seafarer makes and all the investments and their tax benefits. Beautifully explained.
Thank you. Thank you so much for again inviting me on this part two session. And it was, I always enjoy talking about seafarers taxation. And it is quite interesting. And even the main important thing is calculation of NRI days. There are so many permutations and combinations possible in calculation of NRI days. So that is the interesting thing. And also about the investments, where to make investment. And you can always call me whenever, like all the seafarers who are watching this video, you can always call me. My number is there on the link. And you can visit my site also, www.seafarerstax.org, and wherein you can get my number, and you can always contact me.
So guys, nahi suna to main wapis bol deta hu. He has a website, seafarerstax.org. He has his Instagram page, send him DMs. He is happy to give you advice for free, and he will file your income tax returns. And I think it's very, it's online, na? Simple process.
Yes, right? It is virtual. Yes, even if you are sailing, you just have to provide documents on mail or on WhatsApp, and we can file your income tax return. So the physical restriction is avoided due to this virtual income tax return filing.
Okay. So, and friends, I have seen people, you know, the CAs, you know, because of seafarers involve ho jate na, to unka thought process and attitude change ho jata hai. Theek hai, mostly they think about themselves, but he is not unlike those. Trust me. Theek hai. So please get in touch with him. Mera to abhi chal raha hai. I mean, it's taken care of. So definitely someday I'll and we'll meet. No, it doesn't have to be filing income taxes. We'll meet for sure for, you know, have a cup of coffee. So yes, thank you again. Sure. So thank you again for coming live, and thank you for your beautiful explanation. And viewers, this video is available. Follow him on his Instagram page and please check out his website. So thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Chalo. Bye-bye.